your ID process. Tell me how you do your ID process.
Can you ask that in a different, I guess a different question, what kind of ID process?
Yes, how do you go about doing your lineups? Do you bring the suspect in, do you bring the victim in, is it not behind a TV screen, or do you line up people with them, or how do you do it?
So the photo lineups are a set of photos that are, it's an array of photos that are presented to the witness or victim, in this case, a victim and a witness, and in this case, a sequential order, one photo at a time, with a set of instructions that are from our police department.
So you mail them to them?
No, they're, in this case, they were done with the victim. In this case, they were, I utilized a staff member from the Caliente Youth Center to complete the photo lineup for me.
So you had a staff member do your photo lineup, officer?
That's correct.
Why wouldn't you do it yourself?
Miss Vanessa Robinson was away from Las Vegas, and it's often, at times, best practice to have someone that has no knowledge of the investigation or suspect information to complete a photo lineup, so they're neutral in the case, and in this case, I felt it would benefit the case to complete, to take that investigative step and complete the lineup with someone else.
So basically what you're saying is you had staff at Caliente, instead of the police, conduct a photo lineup.
Yes, I did.
So you yourself never did a photo lineup?
Not with Ms. Robinson, no.
So, when you're having a staff do the police work for you, what kind of instructions do it come with?
It comes with the LVMPD instructions that are downloaded from our police department's Word program, and it's, in this case, printed along with a set of photographs and mailed over to Mr. Tyler Peterson.
So do you think this is a secure?
Excuse me?
The method from which you use to identify people, do you think this is secure?
I don't understand the question, Mr. Davis.
Do you think it's secure that you would send over something to a staff, photos to a staff, and tell them, download this, go through these instructions in your letter, and then give it to an alleged victim and then have them pick out some. Do you think that's fair?
Well, objection, that calls for a legal conclusion, fair.
Yeah, I think it's vague, but I also, if you're talking about the reasonableness of
right. The
photo lineup, I think that is a legal conclusion. So if you'd like to rephrase it, if you think it's best practice or something like that.
Do you think this is good practice for the police department?
It's not common practice for me, but in some cases, I have made that decision to do that.
So, why wouldn't you just drive out there and do it yourself?
I chose not to in this case.
Can you tell me why you chose not to in this case?
I had a connection with a staff member, Mr. Peterson, and I made the decision to send the photo lineup over to Mr. Peterson to complete it.
And I'm guessing I'd like to ask you, going back to your Facebook warrant, found out the years was wrong, why didn't you fix it?
I was in preparation for this trial, and I decided not to due to the fact that it could take several weeks to a month to do this, and I had enough information to show communication between the defendant and Vanessa Robinson.
But don't you think a defendant or even a victim would deserve that? The right dates?
Objection, argumentative.
Well, Your Honor, I'm just trying to see why.
Okay, then rephrase, because that system is
okay,
so rephrase, please.
Yeah. I'm trying to understand the importance of these dates are very important. Do you agree?
I do, sir.
So, do you agree that they should have been fixed?
I should have had the correct dates in the first place.
So, in the first place, when you find out they're not the correct dates, don't you think you should have corrected it? No matter if it took a couple of weeks, a couple of months, whatever?
Well, in this case, the purpose of the search warrant was to show communication between Vanessa Robinson and the defendant, and to show the link between both subjects. And I believe I had enough with that information that I had received already from Facebook.
Okay. Saying that's your... Okay, so basically you got all the records from 2015.
That's correct.
What age would Vanessa be in 2015?
She could have been... It depends on the year, but she could have been... When I made contact with her, she was 14, and she could have also been 13 in 2015.
I would like to give you her birthday on the report, but refresh your memory.
Okay.
As soon as I can find it.
Those states admitted one with her birth dates on it.
Okay, so let's tell the detective. So, in 2015 is where your alleged communication between the defendant and the victim happened.
Well, Your Honor, I'm going to interrupt you.
Sure.